Hi, I'm Dombadan from samplelibraryreview.com, and today I'm really excited. We're going to be checking out the Evolution Flatwound Bass by Orange Tree Samples. Now, this is a really cool development. Those of you who've been following along on the channel for know for a while that I'm a big fan of the Evolution engine. Orange Tree Samples has built so many great guitar libraries in thus far, and now they're expanding into bass guitars. First up, they got a sample set from this Fender Precision Bass. It says it's a P-style bass, but I think we all know what that means. Vintage. It's coupled with flat wound strings, and this is going to give it a traditionally warmer and smoother sound. It's going to be probably a wide-ranging tone from 70s rock. Funk. Punk rock. Jazz. It's Motown R&B. Basically just a lot of great tone in this bass. Library downloads is 3.4 gigabytes. It's a sample set from a vintage piece style electric bass with flat wound strings. It is in Orange Tree's Evolution engine, which includes really powerful mapping system for articulations, physical modeling for adjusting your pick positions, and a built-in effects rack. Library includes legato samples for slides, hammer-ons, pull-offs, as well as sustains and a few other articulations, including octaves, grace notes, buzz trills. Yeah, I can't wait to check these out. It is a contact player instrument, meaning it's compatible with both the full and free version of Native Instruments Contact and loads right into your libraries tab. Evolution Flat Round Bass normally sells for $179. At the time of putting this video together, it just came out a couple days ago. It's on its special intro price, $139. So head over there right away if you want to grab it during the intro special. Alright, as you can see, we've got Evolution Flatwound Bass up. I'm going to be just playing through it, listening through a few of the different presets, sharing some of my thoughts on the engine as we go along. The first thing you'll notice right here is the mapping system. And this is pretty incredible. You can assign articulation key switching based on velocity, key switch, latching key switch, sustain pedal, or random, or you can assign it to different controllers. So you could pretty much program this bass instrument to play however you'd like for changing through your articulations. What's cool about the velocity is you can see we could just set sustains up for the higher velocities and palm mutes for the lower. So now we got something like this. So to dive in and get a feel for the instruments, you can see it's one NKI right here in your libraries tab, and then the presets it ships with. Let's have a listen to some of these. So you see we got blue keys that are playing the notes, and right now we're just playing sustained, fingered, sustained articulations because it's velocity ranging from soft to loud. And then at the bottom here we got repetitive strums basically, so it's just fingered up and down. And that way you're able to play, you're able to perform without that space in between of lifting your finger up on a repeated note, because the bass would play repeated notes so often. So let's go ahead and go to another preset. We'll start to hear some of the changes that happen because the instrument has this effects rack in the tone setup, in the tone section, that's changing probably with most of the presets. Yeah. Set up here, because we can hear already we've got a slapped for our lower velocities and a popped for our high velocities. You're able to instantly kind of get a feel for a preset and just see how it responds a little differently to your playing based on the mapping. Of course, this is a bass instrument, so I hope you have your headphones or your subwoofer turned on so you can really feel just how deep, smooth, and creamy this guy is. Here's an interesting one. We got harmonics picked for the lower velocities, and then sustain picks for higher velocities. Kind of a very rock and roll-y sound here, and I can tell, you know, we've got some we've got the distortion turned on here, stomp box distortion, and probably some of a setting for amp, modern gain, and a 4x10 cabinet. And then up here at the top, you might have noticed all along we've had these keys. These are bass sampled noise effects, slides. Some palm slaps. Yeah, I think you could get some pretty fun stuff out of that one as well. So this one sounds like it's got the picked throughout. real nice, bitey sound, kind of vintage. Chorus, probably good for some dub kind of stuff, maybe some reggae, funky breakdown. Let's see what this one's all about. Okay, we got some slapped and popped across our harder articulations. Some just sustains for the lowers. Psychedelic with this little bit of a juicy funk. I think we all know what that's a tribute to. I really like this one. Meter Man. Okay. Probably from the Meters. Really classic kind of sound. Motown. More Motown. Sound. Yeah, the picked gives it that attack right up front for the picked versions of the articulations. Let's see what else we got. Ooh. Very cool sound with that one. Slap Surprise. I guess what it is here, we got sustained fingers up to 89, then we trigger the slap and pop towards the top end. Psychedelic time. This is probably a good time to take a look at the effects again. Got a chorus, and then we must have a phaser. Do we have a phaser? Oh, this wah effect. Quite a few different controls and configurations for the effects units as well. Solid rock. Let's check out the sweet soft harmonics. It sounds like if we have some harmonics on low and then fingered back for our higher velocities. Dinosaur. Pretty appropriate names for these. Thumpy slap. And that one's just using this slapped and popped. And I'm kind of surprised we haven't heard anything a little more out there. Yeah, kind of a modern retro vintage kind of sound on that one. We didn't hear any setup with octaves. Let's just get this guy set up. Pretty. Let's get the octaves on this one here. It's a pretty fun technique. I've often, when I play bass, I'll use an octave pedal once in a while. Now let's play around with something. Something I think that I was kind of surprised to not see here. And let's see if we can find it. You know what? I'll just start over from scratch. Let's start with something really rounded. Okay, this is going to be a good one for us to start with. Let's just get rid of our sustain and do all harmonics. And then let's get a delay going. We're going to have a pretty fun instrument when we're done, if this works out. We could probably even take that further out to get a verb going. Or, I'm sorry, a reverb. Here we go. Might be able to get to a point where we're using something that gives it even more color. I'm starting to dig it. I'm actually going to save this one. Call it out there. Save. Out there. New preset. New user preset. Don Bowden Originals. Let's play a little bit more with... one. I remembered thinking this would be a fun one to really see how far we could go with the distortion on this. Now, I didn't even get into this. What's really cool about these additional parameters through the setup, you've got the pick modeling, which is really cool. If we had a very clean sound, like, let's go back to our, let's see. Now our pick modeling, we're going to go from neck to the bridge. probably not working because we don't have a picked articulation turn on. We're using this here, which is the fingered. So how can you change your picking? And of course, everything, click to learn MIDI CC. You could actually automate all your picking. I know a lot of times you may want to come up to the bridge to get more bite. If you want to have back at the neck for a little wider tone, we get some pick noise. See up here, of course, it's going to be showing you the notes it's playing. You can always change your position. So I could play in fifth position for A. Or it moves up, move that, basically moving where your hand goes. Notice now the presets had a drop D for the bass guitar, but you can achieve that here with your alternate tuning. You can go down to B if you want. Low, low, low. Controls for your legato range, bend mode. Change your bend range, your ability to control your vibratos. So if you're familiar with the Evolution engine, you know probably what you can do, but it's just kind of cool seeing it applied to a bass guitar, because even though it's such a similar instrument, it's still usually treated a little bit differently, and it's great that the Evolution engine, they've utilized so many of the controls, the mapping, the setup. Great set of effects, and my big takeaway is that it's just such a warm, unique sample set to start with, that there's tons of options to really get just about anything out of it. Thanks for taking a little time to spend with me here today to check out Evolution Flatwound Bass. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Please comment below. Tell me what you think about the Flatwound Bass. Are you a fan of OTS, Orange Tree Samples, for those of us in the know? And is this something you're looking forward to, the bass here, as well as could there be more Evolution basses in the works? I'm betting there is. Love your support. Please like, share, and subscribe. And be sure to head over to samplelibraryreview.com for latest news, reviews, and our weekly deals page.